In the beginning of this ops, it seemed like a mission impossible. There were similar cases like the one at Chibodo. In one, for example, there was a judge who threatened to arrest if we ever stepped foot in his house. There was also another judge in Accra who told us to let due process work without any interference. Several other judges had a reputation of integrity, not tolerating any hint of bribery or a suggestion of it. In La Paz, the court clerk was forthright. We sat in the courtrooms of some judges and it was clear our mission was impossible with them. Judges like that immense and constant Omotowu, Ifeasewa Ojo, Jennifer Dodu, Anthony Opon, Gina Mensa Dacha, and Samuel Janiko Ode gave us a hell of a time.
We will never say that there is no problem. Because the moment you accept positively that there is corruption, then you must provide it in law as evidence. As lawyers, we don't give
I'm
not using injustice or whatever we need. So when people have their evidence and they bring it, we shall never relent.
Undercover reporting is meant to uncover issues of national importance that cannot be obtained through direct means. It is a tool of last resort in our fight against corruption and human rights abuses. In the absence of corruption, there will be no undercover reporting. As our months of work uncovered no corruption, the team came up with a plan. We decided to go to bed if we didn't find anything to uncover on this mission. We gave ourselves 6 more months. Then we got a call that changed the whole day.
Hey,
Jesus.
Hello, man. Hello, my brother. Yeah, how much?
Fast Track High Court into the courtroom of Justice Ernest Obimbe. It was the case of a plaintiff suing 3 persons over a piece of land near the Tetekwasi roundabout in Accra. We wanted the judge to deliver judgment in favor of Alpha Musa, who also wanted the same piece of land. Gabriel, a known fixer at the High Court, was there to help us get access to the judge with his magic wand.
We are finding a way of fixing the man. There are people, because they know this, they think you are closer to their gate,
He called the judge's clerk. We met the clerk for a discussion.
Yeah.
Didn't seem favorable, so Gabriel went directly to the judge. It worked. According to Gabriel, the judge demanded 5,000 cedis so he can rule in our favor. We agreed to that. Gabriel also charged a fee of 2,000 cedis for his role as a fixer and broker. We then set a date to meet the judge. Our rendezvous point was the Accra Mall. The judge showed up with his bodyguard to pick his part of the booty, but asked the bodyguard to excuse him before taking the bribe money from us. He then appeared offended that the money wasn't available.